Okay, so we're back in Gaia again, and we're going to try and create ourselves a mesa, which is sort of like one of those desert forms you see out in, you know, Death Valley or whatnot, that have those large standing shapes with an interesting sort of base. And we're going to look at that and also kind of cover some issues that you will have when dealing with this kind of software, when you want to create those sort of things. So in order to start this off, we're going to have to make sure that we have an interesting starting form. So our mountain primitive here gives us something kind of cool, and there are a few different, you know, different types that we can mess around with to get different results. I'm going to stick with C here, but I am going to play with the seed and look at what kind of results that I'm getting off of this. So this is kind of interesting. We'll play around with it a little bit more. There's a peak. I definitely don't want that. It's not too bad. Like something with a little bit more breakup. This is sort of neat. I might be able to get something interesting out of this. You know, I've got like a little peak over here and another one over here. And it really depends on what you want. Now, I understand that as I'm saying this, you don't know exactly what you're going to get from this yet, so let's move forward and you'll get a better idea as we move along. So this place is going to add a little bit more detail. I don't really need it, but I'm not going to throw it away. I'm just going to start with this. This is good enough for now. So we're going to add a node to this, which is going to be our auto level. An auto level is going to immediately give you a bit more height to this overall shape, which is a good starting point for me. I'm then going to go ahead and add the next node that's integral to what we're creating, and that's going to be a clamp node. So the clamp node has a variety of different forms. You can go ahead and clamp it to a specific height, and so that's going to control it's kind of like what you would get from, say, the bias gain node in that particular case. We also have a clipping function where we can go and shave things off and get ourselves a little plateau that we can play with, which is also pretty cool. But I'm going to use the extend feature. So I'm just going to play with this value here, and you're going to see what happens. That starts creating those initial shapes. Now I could have done that without having extended the form, and that would make these, of course, longer. I could use like the clamp initially, to lower the shape, or a bias gain to lower the shape a little bit further if I do want them a little bit longer than this. And that's entirely up to me, or you in this particular case. So this is kind of cool. And you know, the further down, the more I'm going to get to other little peaks and ridges, and it'll make those initial sort of mesoforms and how big you want to create that and generate that. So I'm okay with these kind of like individual shapes, which is sort of neat. I'm just gonna try and watch out for any like little spiky flyaways that are being generated, like these little dudes. There's one there, right? You wanna watch out for those. And that looks good. Now, you should note that I'm doing this at a 512 resolution, and this is important because what I want to do here is create a base shape, something to start with. And what I'm going to do with this next, which helps me create the interesting form, again, it's resolution dependent. So I'm going to go ahead and add a landform to this, which is going to do an erosion and a displace at the same time. and that's going to give me something kind of cool. So this is a really sort of a nice starting point. Now if I were to go up resolution and the landform choose through that, this is also not too bad. It's pretty good. This is chewed through a little bit less. And if I go even further up, as it chews through it, we're going to notice that these things are not going to change shape nearly as much. So they don't modify form quite as much as I would maybe like. So again, it's going to be up to you whether or not you like this end shape, but I tend to want to go a little bit lower as my starting point, and you can continue to modify these after the fact using some of the software like ZBrush to try and get a different kind of height map out of that. And then I'm going to go ahead and add in something else. So I'm going to go and add Talus, and Talus is going to go in and apply some sand or rock around the base, just filling in the form. And it does take a little while to calculate, especially at this higher level, and that fills in all those lower regions. You can decide if you like that, how far it's gone. It's eaten away at this base a little bit too much for me. So I'm going to do something here, and that is I'm going to switch to a graph mode. Switching to graph mode, it doesn't really ask you, it just kind of goes ahead and does it. Whereas if you try and switch from this back to a layer mode, it will freak out a little bit more. And between this and this, I'm not happy with how high it's going. So I'm going to mask this off. I'm going to go ahead and right click, and I'm going to grab a height mask, input my initial height, and that's going to be there. And of course, with the height, we can determine how far up we want to go with the talus here. And remember, don't drag, click, right? So say roughly about there, and we'll go ahead and plug that into the mask on the talus. And the talus will recalculate, and that may take a little while to chew through. That's not too bad, and we get this result, which is pretty cool. Holding down control, I'm just going to move over here. I'm going to save this. So, nice tutorial. Because, just in case any kind of crashes happen while I'm working with this. Now that I've saved that, I'm going to go ahead and grab myself a combiner. The combiner node will look different if you're using it when you generate here versus generating it in layer mode. And what I want to do here is attach it between these two. And the result is, instead of losing everything, I'm only losing about half of it, and so I'm keeping some of that initial detail there while maintaining the rest. I could then go ahead and maybe add some erosion to it if I want, maybe get some additional forms here. So we'll go ahead and create ourselves a J erosion, and I don't really know what the J stands for, if I'm to be honest. But I do know that as an erosion node, this provides a combination of the different elements that I want. So I'm going to get things like what the breaker node produces. I'm going to get some of the regular erosion shapes that I'm used to. And I can increase that. And really what I'm mostly concerned with is these shapes along the base here. Just chewing away at that. Maybe increase the radius a little bit to get some larger gaps. And that's going to make it go a little bit longer. You can hear my fan spinning up like a jet engine. I'm just going to pause. So we're going from that to that, just adding a little bit more detail. And again, this is all just sort of a starting point for me. I want to eat away at the shapes a little bit more, so I'll go with hydro erosion, which is not currently connected. Let's control left click and drag, and we'll add that in there. Let's connect that, and that one, once again, I'm going to want to apply a height mask to it, because I don't want to affect those top forms just yet. I just want to affect the lower regions. So I'm going to change that from a lateral, which is going sideways, that would be kind of like river erosion. I'm going to switch that to ventral, which is going to go and flow downwards, so it's going to soften these contours. And only happening to that lower region, increasing that power. There we go. Soften those ridges. And I'm going to get that detail back in the future build level. So now that I've got this to this level, because of that scale dependent issue, I'm not going to be able to export at 2K and still get the same forms that I want. So I'm really forced here to do an intermediary step. And that is going in and saying, okay, export, save current, and we'll go Mesa base. Now I have Ace of Base stuck in my head. Mesa base. And we'll just go ahead and resave that. Maybe iterate on it. And we're going to then take that that saved information that I've put in here, and we're going to create a new form from that. So we'll go ahead and say new. And that means it doesn't have to reprocess any of that information ever again. It's just going to start from it. So we'll just delete these guys, add our file node, we're going to go ahead and load that file. So there's a Mesa base. Up to 2K, and we've got all that back, but now it can be detailed further. So I can do things like, I say like another landform, creating some interesting little shapes and structures in there. I could go ahead and erode this further instead, or along with this. It's really up to me. I could do things like this like sand dunes, just like we did in the other tutorial, using something like the recurve node. Recurve will process that. And this is where I'm going to want to use direction. So change the direction here. And then I'm going to want to adjust that based on height again, because it's eating away at these top forms. So my graph is down here. We're going to want to grab height information, pull that out once again, and plug that into the mask and allow it to recalculate. And that's the process. So you can continue to add detail. We'll talk more about, you know, some of these other nodes in future videos, but that's the starting point.